Tonight on Bands Reunited. KajaGooGoo, their synth pop sound and bold style made them an instant hit with teen girls everywhere. But in 1983, they stunned millions of their fans by firing their heartthrob lead singer, Limahl.
They felt that by getting rid of me, that they would get rid of the teen label.
Hi, I'm Aamer, Haleem, and this is Bands Reunited, and we're in London. And we have 7 days to bring them back together again.
What's all this about?
Nicky Beggs?
Blimey.
No one explained this to me.
Hi, Stuart. Will we be able to do it?
I don't know whether I want to go there.
How's your relationship with the band today?
Terrible.
In 1983, KajaGooGoo catapulted to world fame with their mega hit. Then came
Hang on now, meet my heart.
Another hit for But the bubblegum image caused tensions within the band.
We were all really, really miserable.
It became clear it wasn't going to sort of work out.
The group fired lead singer Limahl and tried to carry on as a four-piece band without him.
I do think it was the right decision.
It was like a knife in my heart. You know, I was devastated.
But without Limahl's good looks and hardcore teen following, KajaGooGoo vanished from the music scene.
It was going nowhere fast.
Got rid of the wrong person.
It has been 20 years since lead singer Limahl, guitarist Steve Askew, bassist Nick Beggs, keyboardist Stuart Neal, and drummer Jez Strode have performed together. Can they put the hurt behind them? Are they too shy for one more try?
I have my work cut out for me.
We start about an hour outside of London in the small village of Leighton Buzzard. This is the home of three of the original band members.
Welcome to Leighton Buzzard, people. Steve Askew, the guitarist from KajaGooGoo, lives across the street from Nick Beggs, the bassist from KajaGooGoo. We'll start with Steve first.
What's the number again?
39, is it?
I was looking for Steve Askew.
Not here.
Oh, really?
What's all this about?
I'm here from VH1. I have a very special surprise for him. Do you know where we could find him?
He's out at the moment.
Oh.
Maybe if I could talk to you off camera.
Okay.
We could discuss something.
Oh, sure, okay.
We said to her, please don't say anything to Steve, because we're going to come back and surprise him. But we're going to go up the street right now to find Nick.
The town of Leighton Buzzard is so small that three of the band members live within walking distance of each other. Come on, he's here. Let's go.
Are we calling?
Yes, still calling. Hi. Hello. Nicky Beggs?
Yes.
Hi, my name's Aamer from VH1. How are you, mate?
Blimey. I wasn't expecting this. You caught me with my trousers down.
Let me explain why we're here. We've come to the fine town of Leighton Buzzard for a good reason. I've been sent by VH1 and your fans to gather the members of KajaGooGoo. Yes, yes, indeed.
We've tried.
But there's a difference. There's a difference. You know why?
You're going to give us loads of money. Well,
okay, not that part.
All right.
No, we're going to get you in the same room and then put you on stage for a one-night-only special concert.
This is very sweet.
So that's what we're here for. That is what we are attempting to do. We'll take care of everything. We'll facilitate everything.
So the magic question is,
are you in?
I've always been into this.
Yeah! Welcome aboard, Nick. This is awesome. To seal the deal, as they say, I would love your autograph.
Okay, come on in.
Thank you so much. Tell me about a typical day in your life these days.
Well, I'm obviously now a very much a family man. I have 5 children and a dash sexy wife. I've got a studio next door where I record.
So tell me about what happened in the early stages then, as far as this particular band coming together.
We did a series of very high profile gigs to get agents and management involved. One by one, they turned us down. And I just said to the guys, look, this isn't going to work. We need a pivotal person. Somebody told me about this guy called Chris Hamill, who lived in London. I had this sneaking feeling about him that we really should check this guy out. And I was really glad I did, because he had this whole charisma thing going on. I kept looking at him all the time, smiling, just thinking, this is the guy. And we were right, you know, he was perfect.
When we auditioned Limahl, he turned up.
Here we go.
Turned up in black and white gear that really freaked us out. That was great.
Too Shy comes out, and by February 83, it's number one.
Yeah, it was a great time to be a band. It was a great time to be alive and to experience that, although it kind of seemed totally surreal. I don't think I'd really prepared myself for being that successful that quickly.
2 months ago, nobody had heard of KajaGooGoo, but after the release of just one single, things are very different.
Before we knew where we were a global phenomenon. And, of course, you know, that comes with pressures. Fragile minds shift on their axes. Unfortunately for Limahl, we were four friends and band members before he came along. So as hard as he would try, often, he maybe didn't feel as much a part of the project as the four of us. We had obviously achieved a great amount of success in a very short period of time. Even though we'd sold 3 million records, it just wasn't enough to hold the band together. And also, we were all really, really miserable. We wanted the band, for the second album, to develop in the same way as Rio did from the first Duran Duran album. We wanted to take our audience as they were growing up and give them something a little bit more substantial to digest. And we could have done that. But I always felt that Limahl did want to herald back to a very specific teen bop commercial sound, and I think that there was a compromise to be made from both sides.
That could not be reached at the time.
Not be reached at the time because there was too much animosity and bad feeling and hurt, mistrust, and just downright pissed off with the whole thing, had enough of it. We had to stop everything at that point and say, Limahl, I'm sorry, this isn't going to work anymore. We're going to carry on as a four-piece, but you've got to go your own way, and that's what we did. It's funny though, when I was standing there on the forecourt and you came up to me, I did feel like you were kind of like Mother VH1 saying, now children, stop misbehaving. It's time to play nicely together.
Yeah, exactly. Oh yeah. Well, so you're looking forward to the reunion, I think.
I think this could be a tremendous amount of fun.
Thank you, Nick. Thank you.
Before we talk with Nick, he placed a call to another Leighton Buzzard local.
Hello.
Keyboardist Stuart Neal.
Hello, Stubby. How you doing? What's the earliest you can get down? I've got to talk to you about something which I know you're going to be very interested about, but... So, 5:30 in the sun? All right, I'll be there waiting for you. See you later. Bye. Love you. Bye. Kisses. Bye. 5:30 in the sun.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me just say, for the record, Nick? On the team now.
Brilliant. We got KajaGooGoo founder and bassist Nick Beggs. Next, the trap is set at the corner pub.
My name's Aamer. I'm from VH1.
But will the men of Kaja shy away from our reunion?
I don't know whether I want to go there.
Lives change. Yeah, people move on.
And later, heartache and betrayal as Limahl gets the axe.
And I'll never forget, I remember the words. We've decided we're going to carry on the group without you.
Our quest to reunite KajaGooGoo continues. While we wait to ambush keyboardist Stuart Neal at 5 p.m., we decide to see if guitarist Steve Askew is at home.
And I've always been with Paul and ask him to come back for some reason.
Do you want to ask him to hop over to your place?
Yeah.
And then we could have cameras there.
And these gentlemen are going to hide in the trees.
Yeah. All right, that's the plan?
I'm going for a cover. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, this is very. Right. That's
going to be great. Nick, very agreeable. Not only that, but a co-conspirator now.
And so the trap is set for an ambush in Nick's backyard.
There he is. Something's come up. I'm at the garden a minute. VH1 are here.
Hey, Steve, how are you? My name's Aamer from VH1. Oh, yeah. I would like to invite you to a reunion with your old bandmates, KajaGooGoo. I would like to extend that invitation to you and ask if you are in.
Well, I'd have to think about it, I think.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Why do you have reservations?
I don't know whether I want to go there.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Is there anything we can do to help you go there, so to speak?
Well, I guess if everybody else is up for it, I'll do it.
He's in! Yay! Yay! Now, I would like to... I'm glad he thought about it. To seal the deal, if you will, I would love to have your autograph.
Steve and I think probably have had and still have the strongest relationship in the band. And we always make each other laugh. We're a bit like naughty children.
Ladies and gentlemen, he's in. Yay! Welcome aboard. Welcome aboard, gentlemen.
The boys are back in town.
The boys are back in town. During the height of Goo Goo Mania, what did you guys do to sort of, you know, keep your sanity, so to speak?
For us guys that came from Leighton Buzzard, it was, we had each other in many respects, because we all knew each other so well, that you can sort of keep everybody on the ground. And I think maybe in many respects for Limahl, it was a lot harder. He didn't have anybody, you know, that he knew from way back.
Thrilled, overwhelmed, excited, and obviously very busy too.
You know, having such a big hit with the first record, you know, from sort of just doing your day-to-day things that you do in a band, suddenly the next minute you're just flying around to every country in Europe, you know, going to America to make videos, coming back the next day. We weren't used to that.
Right, exactly. It's like the conflict of success, you know?
Yeah, something's got to give, I think. Yeah.
What about your relationship with Limahl?
Obviously, things with Limahl wasn't fantastic because we kicked him out of the band, and I don't think he was too pleased about that. It was very difficult.
Yeah.
It was never an easy decision.
Right.
I think everybody, given hindsight, would change certain things because I wouldn't be so arrogant to say that I got it all right.
Well, thank you very much, not only for agreeing to the reunion, but welcoming us into your home. It's been a pleasure.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Steve. Yeah. Pleasure. Thank you, Steve.
Yeah, thank you.
Gifted guitarist Steve Askew is good to go. There's one more Leighton Buzzard boy left. Stewart expects to share a pint with his mates at a neighborhood pub. The guys are going to need a few more glasses because we'll be joining them too.
And we got Nick earlier. Nick helped us get Steve, and Nick and Steve are now going to help us get Stewart. Come on, it's going to be fun. Hello. Hi. Hi. Hi, Stewart. My name's Aamer. I'm from VH1. Nice to see you, my friend. How are you? Can I pull up a chair? I'm here with some friends for a good reason. I've been dispatched by VH1 and the fans to ask you, my question is, are you open to reuniting with your bandmates for a one-off, one-time special concert reunion?
Yeah.
You're in?
What did I tell you?
Yeah, exactly. Hello. Have you met my co-conspirators?
Well, they were.
Yeah. Hey.
We know these guys quite well.
I know you do. Yeah, you go back.
If they said yes, that's good enough for me.
I just have one order of business to do, to take care of, and that is to ask you for your autograph. There you go.
Limahl's not here, is he?
So they were all in my kitchen.
This was a surprise. So I felt shocked. I felt flabbergasted.
What was it like in those days when you got together with your buddies here in a town a little removed from London? Did you have dreams of going there one day and making it big?
We were very dedicated and determined to be successful. Maybe arrogance, but we did believe that.
It's often written as, well, it was just a simple case of The four guys were upset that they were being perceived as bubblegum teeny boppers, and the one guy they thought was responsible for that image had to be kicked out. And then that was it.
That's true.
Oh, that's it? That is
true. Absolutely true.
Yeah, okay, well, that's good.
Limahl himself is a very strong individual with fixed ideas on things that didn't fit really with some of our ideas. So there was going to be a clash ultimately.
When was the last time the five of you were in the same room together?
We set up a meeting with Jason and Limahl to discuss the possibility of reforming the band.
So it didn't go as well, right?
It didn't quite happen.
Yeah.
Doing something this way is good because that way you're not dragging any sort of business into it. You're just doing it for the music, and I think that is the most valuable way of doing something like this.
It's been a pleasure talking to you and meeting you, and I look forward to seeing you again at the reunion.
Fantastic! Stuart Neal and his keyboards are on board. Next, we track down the elusive drummer.
KajaGooGoo. Have you heard of him?
Or do we?
No, I haven't.
And later, the painful truth behind Limahl's layoff.
They just felt that by getting rid of me, that they would get rid of the teen label.
We were looking at that Limahl was the problem, and he probably wasn't.
It was like a knife in my heart.
Do you get to say this? I'm in London looking for KajaGooGoo.
Now I'm here in this historic city to get singer Limahl and drummer Jez Strode.
I've trained my sights on Jez Strode, the drummer. We've discovered that he owns a music equipment rental company.
Our plan is to lure him to our venue, where we're going to pretend we need his services to rent equipment for a concert. Little does he know, he's in the concert.
Oh, hey, Jez. Pleasure to meet you.
About a five-piece band.
It's a five-piece band, yeah.
Okay, and you're going to use a drum riser for the kit?
Well, I think that's what the drummer wants. I'll have to ask him. This is such a special band, and somewhat temperamental personalities.
I'm sure he knows the band.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter at this point. There's loads of questions here, and we've got to be overcome and just try and think.
Did we already talk about the style of music, if that mattered at all?
Who is this band?
Can you say? Yeah. KajaGooGoo. KajaGooGoo, yeah. Have you heard of them?
No, I haven't.
Even from back in the day, Too Shy.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Okay,
so what is this, a revival or something?
No, it's the original band members. Have you heard of this band?
No, I told you I didn't.
Oh, you didn't? Oh, sorry.
What's your name again? My name?
Yeah.
Paul.
Oh, Paul.
Yeah.
Not Jez Strode. Jez, my name's Aamer.
Hi.
I'm VH1. You basically killed us. I'm here.
Too clever for you, weren't
you? Yeah. This has never happened before.
Well unexpected.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you can really roll with it, my friend.
So there's no business here for me.
Well,
I'm making you money.
Are you open to the idea of reuniting with your old bandmates, particularly for a one-off show?
It's been put forward a couple of times.
Yeah. If we actually made it so that it was possible for you to get on stage with the guys and perform, would you be in?
Well, I mean, obviously, I can meet with the guys, you know, if they're up for it. I mean, I'm open.
What were you thinking when you asked about the name of the band and I said KajaGooGoo?
I couldn't really believe it, and then I thought I'd just play along and just sort of run it through the course and see what's happening.
It should be interesting, because I don't know how long it's been since Jez has picked up a pair of drumsticks.
Do you play still?
I don't play at this time. I don't even have a drum kit at the moment.
You have to get a drum kit as well. When you look back at the fashion of the time and what you guys tried to put out as your image and the hair and all that, did you then see that people weren't taking you as seriously in terms of your music?
Yeah, I mean, we come to a point, really, that we were saying we want to be known for our music, but if the image is taking over, then that's not good.
Is that what became the breaking point with the band and Limahl?
I got a lot of sympathy for the situation with Limahl. We sacked Limahl, and I was part of that sacking. We were looking at
that Limahl was the problem, and he probably wasn't. In hindsight, I probably would have rather got rid of the manager than Limahl.
So you're looking forward to this reunion, if I can make it happen?
You would be a miracle worker if you could.
Jez is picking up his sticks and joining the party. But our biggest challenge lies ahead.
Beach Blanket Babylon, really cool hangout, and this is where I'll be hanging out with Limahl from KajaGooGoo.
We invited Limahl to sit down and talk to VH1 about his current solo career. He has no idea we want him to reunite with the same band that fired him almost 20 years ago.
Well, Limahl, thank you very much for sitting down with us. I was wondering what kind of musical style you established with the band.
We were all being influenced by what was around at the time. Eurythmics, Soft Cell, Duran Duran. I just was so blown away by that. I was just bursting with the ideas. And I just thought, I'm going to form my own band. So I put an ad in the important music paper in London then. They rang me up. And I went to see them. It was an audition I needed to impress. You know, I wanted to go, pow, here I am. And it really worked. They loved me.
Tell us how meeting Nick Rhodes from Duran Duran
led to, I guess, a record deal with EMI.
I'd been with the band for a year, and we'd written songs every day, every week. I can remember the call. Limahl, it's Nick Rhodes. And I've got your tape, and I really like it. I'm going to take it into EMI Records.
What's the purpose of your visit to EMI?
Well, it's for two purposes. Obviously to say thanks to everybody for working on our behalf, and see how it's done.
It all seemed to be happening quite fast now. By this point, we suddenly became this kind of teen sensation. Screaming fans at airports, at hotels, fainting in the audience, and it was really silly. And they didn't like it. And they thought that I was to blame.
Why couldn't they talk to you about the fact that, for some reason, your presence is creating that label of teeny bop or teen music?
They just felt that by getting rid of me, that they would get rid of the teen label.
What was that famous, or now infamous, phone call like?
It was like a knife in my heart. Because I had felt so instrumental in the success of the group. It was my friend who bought the equipment. It was me who met Nick Rhodes. And I was part of the songwriting. I mean, I was so integral in the past of the group. I was just kind of left out on my own to work everything out in my head. I mean, looking back, I'm angry about that.
How's your relationship with the band today?
Terrible.
Really?
It's terrible. I know. We got together, we talked about a reunion. I hadn't seen them for 20 years, 18 years or something. And we couldn't even come to agreement, you know.
Oh, because of?
I'd made a few stipulations, and they didn't want to meet them. So I said, you know, bugger off.
There are a lot of contractual things and business things, I think, that people feel a little bit hard done by.
This program is devoted to finding members of bands and then also extending an invitation to attend a reunion.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Of KajaGooGoo.
Of KajaGooGoo.
No one explained this to me.
Well, this is the reality part of the show, is that we wanted to get an honest reaction from you.
Oh,
to be,
I see.
To be quite honest, you know.
Oh. Well, that's weird. I wonder what they'll say, you know, because the last time I saw Nick, we had some very acrimonious emails.
You know, the thing about emails, they can be misunderstood.
I can print them off and print them.
Well, I mean, wow. If everyone is up for it, would you be interested in participating? Could we include you on?
Hey, life's too short.
You're in?
Yeah.
All right, welcome aboard. Thank you, Limahl. That's wonderful. This is a big step for us, Limahl. Wow. Thank you so much. Yeah. Pleasure talking to you.
Wow.
All right, the final piece of the KajaGooGoo puzzle is in place. Limahl is on board. Next, can the sack lead singer put his hurt to rest, and how will the rest of the band feel about it?
They said Limahl's coming today.
He won't come, you'll say. No, I'm not coming.
Big decision.
Bands Reunited has done what no one has been able to do for 20 years. Get the original five members of KajaGooGoo back together again. Let's hope there's still some love left for Limahl at this reunion.
Hello, Stuart. How are you, sir?
I'm very well.
Good. Good to see you.
See you too. Are they here already?
I can't say.
I'm not really nervous. Looking forward to meeting them and playing with everyone. So it's going to be a good day.
There he is. The one, the only, Nick Beggs. How are you, sir?
I'm very well.
During your trip here, what were you thinking about? What were your thoughts?
I'm just looking forward to playing together again after so long. It feels like I had a band once, and I was in an accident, and I lost my memory, and then was in a coma, and 20 years later I've woken up, and here I am, back in it again. Oh, blimey.
What are you doing here, man? They said Limahl's coming today.
No, he's not. He's not coming. He won't come. He won't come, you'll say. No, I'm not coming. Do I think he'll turn up?
Especially after what I said to him last time.
Yeah.
Hey, Steve, how are you, sir? Yeah. Good to see you.
You too.
How was the trip down from Leighton Buzzard?
It was great.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm still awake, so it's the main thing, yeah. I certainly don't really carry any sort of bad feelings or baggage with me. I mean, I'd be very happy to, you know, to work with the guys, whatever.
Hang on, look at this.
Who's that coming in now?
Hey!
Did you get the limo treatment? I did.
Good to see you.
Hey there, Janice.
Hello.
How are you?
Hi.
Good to see you again.
You well?
I'm well indeed. Any nervous tension at all?
Yes.
Butterflies, really?
Can't see them fluffy. Catching
butterflies. I hadn't picked up sticks, drumsticks, for the best part of 20 years. Not at all.
Look. Jeremy Strong! You look great.
Hi, Steve.
Look at the size of this guy.
I'm going to wake up any moment.
Yeah. Have you seen Limahl?
No, I haven't.
Well, hello.
Oh my God, I'm here. Hello. Oh, it's early.
It is.
And I can't sing early. This is way deep down in there for me. You know, this is going like 22 years. This was the group that really made my dream come true. There's going to be a lot of undercurrents. You know, like the swan. It might seem graceful on the top, but peddling like hell underneath.
Because Limahl and Nick were the creative core of the band, we decided to give them a few moments alone.
Hey. You recognized it.
Hey!
I could hear you singing the melody.
Oh.
Oh yeah.
How do you feel?
I just kind of tell myself, you know, just enjoy it. It's just a little gig with me old mates. How hard can this be?
That's right. I scattered so much earth over the whole thing. I felt that I'd laid it to rest, but I felt that it wasn't buried deep enough down that I couldn't get to it quite easily.
Yep. What we're bringing to it now, I hope, is a lot more experience.
Thought, well, you know, life's too short. Just
yeah.
Do it.
Yeah.
Aren't you the guy that sang Hush Hush?
Do you know what I've had a few times? They've said, didn't you used to be Nick Beggs?
Yes, and I still am him. Hey. How are you, Stuart? You all right?
Oh, yes, it's Limahl.
Yes, it is me. This here is another one. Hey. How are you, Steve?
You're right. Good to see you.
Good to see you. I said to Nick when I came in, it took VH1 to get us together because we couldn't do it. 4 years ago!
Oh, no.
Look at him! How come you look so good? Look at him!
Tell me how you feel now that you've had some time together again. What emotions are stirring within you?
I feel like I thought I would feel.
Yeah.
Very happy. Great to see everyone again. Great to catch up. Just feels really good.
It's a bit like old times. I mean,
really?
That was an important part of our life. It never leaves you.
What was the last gig that the five of you played together like? Tell me about that.
It was Finland.
Finland.
It was Finland. 40,000 people. It was a pop festival.
That's right. It was a bad vibe. There was a lot of subtext to the way we were all feeling at the time, and you know, Limahl was very much probably feeling isolated.
It started to fragment. Why? Why did it start to fracture?
It's because we became a teeny band. Or that seemed to be the main focus.
Yeah.
And the guys thought it was my fault because I was the pretty one.
Why did it come down to a phone call?
I think each one of us was complicit in running away from the responsibilities of dealing with it, because we left our manager to talk to Limahl. He told us that he didn't meet him, that he just decided to call him. And I remember smarting and thinking, that's not right.
I think there was a personality clash directly with management and Limahl. Mm. And I think we got rid of the wrong person.
Mm. It doesn't mean that we're not happy where we are in our lives right now, because you just get on with it, don't you?
Yeah. Yeah.
But you can't help wondering, well, what would have happened if?
Gentlemen, thank you very much for your time.
Whatever's easiest. As it doesn't matter, does it, here?
No.
What we do first.
Do you want to try a bit of the harmony?
It was really scary. You have a thousand doubts, you know, in your head.
Oh, you don't do the long?
No, it's a short. It's a short.
Okay.
I felt nervous for Limahl. I wanted him to feel at ease.
It's really strange, you know, I woke up this morning, I had no voice. I had to search on the internet for my own lyrics, which was quite amusing.
Either way. I'm just hoping that Jez will be able to cope okay, because he hasn't been playing drums for a long time.
I'm feeling excited, nice to get back on the kit, a bit rusty, and you know, but we'll get the tightness. We'll get there.
I need to change these keyboards around. Sorry.
It is a hard one, isn't it? Because we haven't played those songs for 20 years together.
Next, the Kaja faithful are out in force. But can the two shy guys still play live?
We're going to make some mistakes tonight. You know, there's no toys about it.
There's a full moon over London and a full house for the show.
Ladies and gentlemen, KajaGooGoo!
It's showtime, and the original members of KajaGooGoo will play together for the first time in almost 20 years.
Tonight when I'm on stage and the first few bars of the song start and I look over and I see Jez and Limahl and Steve and Stuart all there, it's going to feel amazing. It's going to feel very emotional. As far as any particular individual having a hard time or the hardest time, I think Jez probably will, because he hasn't played.
A little rusty, probably. I haven't played since I left the band. I haven't picked up a set of drumsticks.
So getting back into it is, you know, just takes a little time. But I'm there nearly, I'm there.
When we step on stage tonight, it's going to conjure up many memories. There are no sort of cover-ups. It's there, people will see us, they'll hear the mistakes, because we're going to make some mistakes tonight. You know, there's no toys about it.
The funny thing is that going through the songs again, you're starting to discover where your headspace was 20 years ago. And that's quite an interesting journey, I think.
Tonight's going to be really intimate. For the fans who've come, it's just going to feel like they're with us. going to be really nice.
Well, this is very cool. Sound check is done. The crowd is in. They're very excited. Everything is set and ready to go. The only thing left to do now is to bring on KajaGooGoo.
This has been 20 years in the making. They said it couldn't be done, but we found them. We reunited them. And for you tonight on stage, KajaGooGoo is on.
Experience that VH1 has given to us has been life-changing at many levels. I can guarantee you, whatever happens, it's been life-changing.
Sort of rebuilding relationships that, you know, broke down 20 years ago, and that, I guess, you know, we're that much older and wiser about, you know, life in general.
With me, Shasha, hush, hush, I do I. Shasha, hush, hush, I do I. To Shasha, was hush. Shasha, hush, hush, I do I. To Shasha, hush, hush, I do I. To Shasha, hush, hush, I do I. To
This is a really important night for us. It's 20 years.
All right, here we go.
Pretty accomplished musicians, so seeing them all get back together and do it well was quite good.
I thought Limahl sounded really good. No sooner than
I turn my back on them. I think Limahl was superb. I think Limahl is a lot more mature, and he's a nice girl.
It's all felt really nice. You know, there's been no bad feelings at all, which is remarkable. What really surprised me was I started crying. Well, not crying, but just like really filling up.
And Limahl was about to cry. It's a very emotional day, you know.
I've got tears in my eyes.
Made everyone feel a part of it. Made everyone feel the same thing. I think everybody gave Limahl a kiss at that point.
Forgiveness is the key. You have to move on. And that's what happened. So, yeah. It was superb.
VH1
are in. Hi, Stuart. Hi, my name's Aamer.
Hi.
Hello. Nikki Beggs. I would like to invite you to a reunion.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Of KajaGooGoo.
Of KajaGooGoo.
This, what is it? Who is it?
Wow. Yes, indeed. The ultimate payoff of perhaps performing together.
Well,
possibly, yeah.
Yeah.
Life's too short.
You're in?
Yeah.
Yes!